Mr. Speaker, the number of NATO member countries meeting their 2% GDP commitment is expected to rise from 7 last year to 18 later this year. Indications from the US are also that the US government is more likely to release expected $60 billion of commitment to Ukraine once Republican congressmen have had their primaries. Could the Minister please confirm to the House that British defence industry at home is now on a war footing, and that we are best able to spend UOR urgent operational requirement money and deliver it for Ukraine?
Well, my honourable friend, as ever, asked an excellent question. I think the point is, which he's really highlighted, this has to be an international effort. And I know that there is a tendency to, shall we say, overplay the negative voices. I think my experience, certainly, of where I've been in these international meetings, overwhelmingly the consensus, huge desire to keep supporting Ukraine in every way possible, from small nations to large nations. Obviously, the role of the US is absolutely fundamental. But yes, I can give him that assurance. I'm clear I want to work with British defence industry to ramp up production. We'll be bringing forward a munition strategy soon. And the goal of always on production would be the one which would be most in the interest both of the military and of our defence sector.